This has been an excellent hearing. We're going to have to bring it to a close. I have just one or two comments and questions. I turn it over to Senator Murkowski for final remarks. But I want to thank you all for your patience, your excellent testimony. Of course, everything will be submitted to the record. But let me just bring this back locally to the U.S. and particularly to Louisiana and the Energy Coast. Designing an energy policy, which this committee will be focused on, promoting America as an energy superpower, will create thousands and thousands of jobs here at home and abroad, and will help us promote democracy, which is one of the central principles of the existence of our nation. I know that we've spent a lot of time talking about Europe and the Ukraine, but we've also started this hearing by talking about the 37,000 jobs in Louisiana and Texas and the Gulf Coast that can be created right now with the production and opening up of exports for liquefied natural gas. Let me also assure my colleagues, mostly Senator Sabno and Senator Baldwin, who were very respectful and appropriate in their comments, and I want to be the same. Louisiana is the second largest producer of gas in this country, offshore and on, but we're also the third largest consumer of gas. It is certainly not in this senator's interest to promote a policy where the prices would skyrocket and put our consumers at a disadvantage. We have industrial consumers, commercial consumers, residential consumers. But the facts are, and I think the case has been made overwhelmingly by a variety of different reports, that opening up export markets helps to increase domestic supply, not close it down, increase it, of gas and natural gas. It also will help to create jobs here at home and abroad. And the price, as you all said, Louisiana, the U.S., because it's North Dakota production, Texas, Oklahoma, Colorado, will always have an advantage because we are the source of the product. Now, yes, does thought have to go into it? Is it the silver bullet? You know, the silver bullet? No, but it's part of, I think, the equation of how to create jobs at home, promote America's strength abroad. The three questions I have, and we're not going to take time, I may just ask you all to submit these in writing for the committee. One other thing that we can export, and Alaska's proud of this, Louisiana and Texas are proud of this, is our technology. It's not just our gas and oil that we can export, both refined and crude, but our technology. And what could we do as better as a country, and we're going to do these answers in writing, to encourage technology, not just from the big oil companies that, of course, have their own ability to do that, but the thousands of small independent producers that sometimes find it difficult to work overseas, how could we assist them to, you know, to promote and export their technology, which is value added to American inventors, et cetera? That's one question for the writing. The other is, we've talked a lot about America. I'd like to talk about North America. I'd like to talk about the power of Canada, America, and Mexico as a major energy producer and supplier. And what's recently happened is a game changer with the government of Mexico moving for the first time to privatize their energy sector. So they're reducing their corruption, opening up the private market. Mexico is a really big place with a lot of big promise. It sits very close to us. I'd like our country to start thinking about Mexico. And, of course, building the Keystone Pipeline, in my view, and using Canada and Mexico, the North American Alliance of Energy is a powerful, powerful tool. And finally, I don't want to underestimate my colleague that Senator Barrasso, you know, says that if we would just streamline these processes, yes, and I'm for streamlining, I'm for expediting. But I also hope that critics of the administration will focus on what can we do to help the Ukraine minimize its corruption? What can we do to, you know, to enhance the $1 billion that you said, Mr. Chao, was just a drop in the bucket? For the record, you should submit what you think a significant investment to the Ukraine would be that would send the most positive signal. So while there's a lot of criticism going around from one side to the administration, I would also like to go on record saying for my colleagues, and this is not Senator Murkowski, but others on the Republican side, put your money where your mouth is. You want to help? Let's step up with some additional funding to help the Ukraine and not just blame somebody else because permits are going a little slowly. And I'll let you have the last word.